Okay, so next topic in this is representation of set. So whenever certain set is given to you, then there are three methods to represent the set. First method is description method. Suppose if I write A is equals to, suppose I write only natural numbers. Okay, so this is my set. I have just given the description of the sets. In roster method, what we are writing? We are writing the elements of the set. For example, this is our description method. And for this, what will be our roster method? 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on like this. So this is the roster method. In roster method, we usually write the, we always write the elements in the set. Next is the set builder method. So suppose a set is given to you and you have to write this into the set builder like in a general form. So how do we start? Okay, so but difference between this and this, in this you will start like this. You will write x is such that, this is such that x belongs to natural numbers, or you can write complete, or you can write in short also. Okay, so you can identify the difference between the in the description. We are simply writing the statement for describing a set. In case of the roster method, we are writing the elements in the set. In case of the set builder method, we are adding this extra term. X is such that X belongs to natural numbers. So this is how we can represent the sets. Then, let's talk about the cardinal number. Okay, cardinal number means number of elements in a set. For example, a set I am writing, suppose 1, 2, 3. So how many elements are there in this? Only 3 elements. So this is how we denote cardinal number, and then in bracket we will write the set name is equals to 3. Okay, so this is the meaning of cardinal number of a set, number of elements in a set. Okay, let's discuss our very first exercise. So suppose in the first question, we have to express the sets in roster form. Okay, so like I have told you, roster form means we have to list the elements. Okay, so suppose a set is given like this, is an even prime number and x is less than equal to 11. Okay, so we have to write the number of elements in the set. So this is set builder form. Now a prime number which should be even, so there is only one number which is even, that is 2. So this is the element of the set, that is 2. Suppose something is given like this, x is a letter in word, statistics. Okay, so how do we write the elements? A, then this T will not count because T we had already written. Now we will write I, then we will not again write this S because S is already written. Then again we will not write T, then we will again not write I, what is left? C. Okay, so you can see I have not written the repetitive elements, I have only written the distinct elements in this set. Okay, suppose the question is like this, X belongs to natural number and X lies between 3 and 11. Okay, so this is important. Many questions will be like this. Now what is the meaning of this? Okay, so if you read it, what does it mean? It means x greater than 3. Okay, so x should be greater than 3. And what is the meaning of this? X is less than 11. So when we combine these two, Okay, understood it very carefully. When we suppose combine these two like this, so what is the meaning of this statement? It means x is greater than 3 but less than 11. Okay, this is the meaning of this type of inequalities. So all the natural numbers which are greater than 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Why till 10? Because it is less than 11. Okay, so this is your set. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, suppose in this question, what we have to see whether the sets are equal or not. So, equal set means when the set contains the same type of elements. So, first we will convert this set builder into the roster form like this. All the natural numbers less than 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if you see carefully, it contains 1, 2, 3 and it contains only 1, 2, 3. That means A is not equal to B because they do not contain the same type of element. Suppose it is like this, a set is there, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and Q contains even numbers less than 12. Okay, so if I write the Q, it is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, is it? All the even numbers which are less than 12. And this is P, so if you see carefully, whatever elements P are having, same elements Q is also containing. That means now we can write P is equals to Q. Okay, so this is how you can see whether the sets are equal or not. Now coming to one more problem, equivalent sets. So suppose it is given X is equals to, X is a prime number. Okay. So what will be our set? All the prime numbers from 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13 and so on. Okay, these are the prime numbers. So we cannot write the cardinal number of this set. Then what is Y? Y is an odd number. An odd number from 1 to 10. Again, this inequality. X is greater than 1. And less than 10 and is an odd number. So it is 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay. So you can clearly see that we cannot write the cardinal number of nx. Okay. Nx will be undefined. But this you can write the cardinal number of this set, that is 4. That means we can say A is not equivalent to B. Okay. Same number of elements should be there. Okay, now suppose two more sets are given, P is equals to ABCD and Q is equals to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So if you take out the cardinal number of P, what will be its cardinal number? 4. If you take out the cardinal number of Q, again it is 4. That means number of elements are same. So we can write P is equivalent to Q. So again, I am repeating, you remember the difference between equal and equivalent set. Equal set means when the two sets contain same type of elements and equivalent means when they contain same number of elements. Okay. Let's discuss one more question. Question number 5. What is P? P is X. X belongs to natural number and X square less than 30. And Q is X, X is factor of 20. Okay, now what? We have to write the value of all the X such that X square is less than 30. So if you put N is equals to 1, first natural number if you put, what you will get? 1 square is equals to 1. So this is my first element. Then we will calculate 2 square is equals to 4. Okay, so this is my second element. This is first. This is second. Then 3 square is equals to 9. Again, one more element. 4 square is equals to 16. So 4 is also my element. 5 square is equals to 25. 5 is also my element. 6 square is equals to 36. So this you will not take. So all the natural numbers whose square is less than 30. So that will be your set P. So what is your P now? P will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then all the factors of 20. So I hope you all know how to calculate the factors of 20. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, 20. Okay. Now for the questions, what we know? First part is n q minus n p. So first we will calculate n of p. So what is n of p? 5. What is n of q you got? 6. So what is nq minus np? 6 minus 5, that is 1. Then np into nq upon n of q square. Np 5, nq is 6. Nq square means 6 into 6. Okay, like this. Then in the last part, we have to prove something. So let's see whether we get our proof or not. So it was np square upon nq square minus np square. Okay, so what was our p? 5. So we will write 5 square. Upon q is 6 square minus 5 square. So it is 25 upon 36 minus 25, that is 25 upon 11. So we can see easily that our LHS is equals to RHS, hence 2. Okay, so this is how you can write the cardinal number of the set. First you list out the elements like I have listed out like this. Then you will write the cardinal number of the set like this. Then you will solve the required expression. Okay, so this is your exercise 6.1. Next is our operation on sets.